in English, we tend to just make the name shorter. So my full name is Ashley, but we just make it shorter, so it's a little bit less complicated. So now you've drawn the in the movie structure, we saw that the left-hand side going along with the, and that didn't happen with the cylinder. And there's a fancy word for that. Fancy's precise way. The word we associate to this property is, we say the Möbius strip is not orientable, but don't be too worried about it. It's a long word. Möbius strip is not.
Ориентируемая поверхность и неориентируемая поверхность.
Orientable. Whereas the cylinder, don't be too concerned about these big words. What I'd like you to do is, when it's a fun with the Möbius strip, this is a really, really interesting topological object. Let's start with the cylinder. So, on the cylinder, you've drawn a line along the centre. Okay. What I'd like you to do is cut along that line. Okay. So if I steal yours for a prop, along the centre line of the cylinder, I'd like you to cut along. Okay.
Mergers or
cylinder. Also, ideally, I'd like you to. Yeah, it turns out to be the same, but ideally, if I could borrow this for a second. Sorry. Ideally, I think. For the sake of the membership. What I mean is to. I mean to pick a point and poke the scissor through that point and then cut like this instead of flattening it. Oh, yeah. The same line. Are you ready? Okay, good. And so what have you got? What have you obtained? Describe what you've got there. Two cylinders. So you come on the centre line and you get two cylinders. Okay, that's right. Okay, so I'll do the same. I'm on the centre line. So do the same for the Möbius strip, but make sure to draw along the Möbius strip, do the same thing. So poke in a hole and cut along. No, if you do it along the centre, let's do it and see what you get. On the centre line. Make sure you stay on the centre line. So that's why it's helpful to have a centre line. Okay, so that's the cylinder. Okay, so when you cut out the cylinder along the centre line, what did we get?
Two cylinders.
We got two cylinders. Let's see if we can see it in the Gruen diagram. So I'm going to cut along here. Can I get this? Two cylinders. And if we cut along the Möbius strip along the centre, so what have you got there?
Yes. Just a single cylinder. Actually, it's not a Möbius, right?
Oh, so how can we decide if it's a?
Well, you can follow the one side, and you will not get to the other side of it.
Okay, so let's start. So this is what a topologist does. How can I tell these two things apart? So let's first, we initially discovered that cylinders. How many sides does a cylinder have? Two sides, and how many sides did a Möbius strip have?
One.
Okay, so how many sides does a thing you've got have?
Two.
So can it be a Möbius strip?
No.
So it can't be a Möbius strip. And how many edges does it have?
Two.
So follow along one edge with your finger. One edge. How many edges?
Edges?
Two. Two edges?
Yes, two edges.
What about is it orientable? Is it orientable if you draw a one and a two, if you draw your right, and you follow on the centre? Is it orientable?
Yes, it is orientable.
It's orientable, two edges, two sides. But so what's different about it?
When the cylinder has no flips, this one has two of them. So, because, since, чётное, как будет?
Even.
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 Even. Since they both have an even number of twists, they behave similarly.
So what is a twist?
I can't describe.
Turn.
Well, then. Okay, let's say so. You have a piece of paper, a line of paper. Yeah. You cut it. Yes. So you cut it, twist it, and glue it back again. Back together.
Okay, so I have a question then. If you were to get a glowing diagram, please, if you would describe your object with a glowing diagram, how would you describe with a glowing diagram?
Well, I would show two. I would just get two stripes and two Möbius stripes.
So I'm going to draw a rectangle.
Yes, and another rectangle. I mean, this may describe it with two rectangles. This one would be twisted with this one, and this one would be twisted with this one.
Okay, so I'm going to take your two rectangles, okay, take this guy, and flip it over, okay? So everyone just imagine, so take this thing, this rectangle.
Yes, I understand, so this turns into a cylinder.
Okay, so flip it over.
Yes.
So now this arrow is going up, and this one is going down. Okay, so just, do we see what happened here?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, now this edge is supposed to be glued to this edge. This edge is going to this edge. So now, when you make it look shorter, now move this guy up to here.
Yes, that's why I said that they behave similarly. But actually, you know, when you twist it twice, when you twist it like this and then back like this, when it is at 360 degrees, it's
Андрей,
the same as
Андрей,
when you don't
он,
twist it at all.
Он сейчас интересуется только поверхностью, как абстрактным объектом, а не тем, как она расположена в пространстве.
Oh, okay, then that's the same, I guess.
So we said it's the same glowing diagram as a cylinder. So it's the same two-dimensional object as a cylinder. But somehow it's different. It's the same two-dimensional surface, but it's different the way it sits inside three-dimensional space. Okay, so it's because it's, which is, I don't want to go in too much detail on that for the moment, but the idea is somehow the cylinder is sitting inside three-dimensional space differently to the ordinary one. But if we just sit on the cylinder, the person living on the cylinder can't tell the difference. Can't tell the difference. And the way to tell yourself that is they have the same glowing diagram. So the idea is that if you're on the cylinder, you can't tell the difference between that cylinder and that cylinder. But if you're off the cylinder, looking from a three-dimensional viewpoint, then you can see there's some difference. It's a little bit complicated, but it's quite interesting. Okay. All right. Now, what happens when you cut the Möbius strip along the center line? Oh, we just did that. Okay. What happens when we cut along? Now, I'd like you to do the following: draw a line along a third of the way. And a line along two-thirds of the way on your Möbius strip. So if I can steal yours may borrow yours for a prop again. So on your Möbius strip, I'd like you to draw a line a third across, and then another one two-thirds across, and follow the one That's a third across. Let's do a line continuing along, okay?
Но у них уже нет листа медузы.
And the same for the two thirds. And then we're going to cut along those two lines.
Антон Ильич said that we don't have paper. I mean, should we glue another one?
Yes, please.
Yeah.
Так, ребят, пожалуйста, надо взять именно лист Мёбиуса.
So
не новую штуку вашу резать, а лист Мёбиуса.
But also, if we run out of paper, these papers, we can always make our
own. Надо заново сделать лист Мёбиуса, после этого его разрезать.
На одну треть от поверхности, ну, от стороны. На две трети.
Смотрите, что делает хитрый Коля. Сначала разрезал, потом клеит. Маленький лист Мёбиуса.
From here to cut over here.
Oh, so cut along the third line first, and then cut along the two third line.
Ah, okay.
Сначала по линии на треть, потом на две трети.
Зацеплены. Они одинаково вложены в трехмерное пространство или нет?
Obviously, I got something strange because one of them is longer than another one.
Yeah, but to a topologist, they're perfectly the same length.
Much bigger and.
But remember, the size doesn't matter to a topologist.
Yeah, then they are. Oh, wait a second. So this is the other one, and this is. Another movement. And that's a cylinder. A twisted cylinder. Okay, just cylinder.
So, both answers are absolutely correct. There's one, so one is from the two-dimensional aspect. It's a cylinder, topologically, but also how it sits inside three spaces is different. Well, Liana, you've also got that. Do you see what you've got? What is one of, what are the two objects?
One has two sides,
and the other one has
one.
Five. Each. Did you mean this, this edge?
I think
yes,
the
inch
is one, has the only one
inch. Inch. Mm-hmm. How many inches did you count up your inches? I'd like you to hold up your examples. If you've just got a very large. Okay, so what if we. And we sit so how many inches did you did this guy have?
2 inches,
and this guy has how many inches?
One inch.
Okay, so can we decide what we got? So we got two different two-inch objects, two different surfaces. And what were they?
A movie strip and a cylinder.
And somehow they were, well, on the one hand, the cylinder was twisted, like the earlier cylinder we had. And not only that, what else was different about this? Have I got an example?
They're ripped to each other.
Have you got a Möbius band for me? Does anyone have a Möbius band? I can borrow it. Just a spare Möbius band.
I could make one.
Oh, you cut them, I see, that's why we don't have anything. Well, let's imagine I've got a Möbius band in my right hand. So what's the difference between a cylinder and a Möbius band and what you guys have got?
Those ones are grabbed, this one. Ours are grabbed to each other.
They're somehow linked to each other.
Yes.
You're living on...
I wouldn't notice that.
Hmm?
I wouldn't be able to notice that.
You wouldn't be able to notice that. So, do you know what I mean? Thank you. So if you're a person living alongside this Möbius band, or a person living inside on this Möbius band, all you would see is that you're on a Möbius strip. One thing, you'll never see the cylinder. Which is the same as if you're on this Möbius band. You never see the cylinder. Do you see what I mean? So just you're only allowed to look in two directions. My right? On my Möbius strip and my straight here. So I can't look out to the outer world. So a person living alongside this Möbius band is in the same situation as a person living on this Möbius band. So they can't see this. It's like you become God. You need God vision to be able to see this phenomenon. So topologically they're the same. From the two-dimensional aspect. Okay, that's it. Let's see if we can detect this using the Gouin diagram. Okay, so let's see if we can decide just from a Gouin diagram what happens when we cut. Okay, so let's start with the cylinder, and I'll slow this down. Let's look at predicting.
Предсказание результатов.
So let's start with the cylinder. Okay. And in the cylinder's case, we cut along the center line. So we're going to cut along the center. It must be useful to have some colors. Okay, so we're going to cut along this thing. Okay. And so before I do that, so remember that this arrow pointing up, means that this point is going to be blurred to this point. So I'll draw in colors, that's good. And I'm going to draw this in red. Draw what we started off with. Okay, so I've just redrawn it. So notice that on our cylinder. So this point here was going to be glued to this point. Okay, so this point being this point. And this point is going to be glued to this point. Okay. And so I've just drawn it with green and red just to make the separation a bit there when we cut. But I haven't changed it. Okay. So now we do our cut. Then we get two rectangles. And we've got our red. And we've got our green. Okay, so I just drew our original cylinder with some color coding so that it's a bit clearer when we cut what we get. So now we've done the cut. What is Eva, can I pick on you for a second? Can you tell us what is this object? If you did the gluing for this thing, what would you get? You get a cylinder, good, and the same for... So these are two cylinders. And that was what happened when you did the cutting of the cylinder. You got two cylinders. Okay. What about when we do the movie strip? That was a cylinder. Let's do the same for the movie strip. And again, I'll color it. So this is what the Möbius strip looked like. Okay, but now if we're here, is that being glued to this point?
No.
It's lower down, it's this point here. So that green is going to this green. And what direction of the arrow should this be going?
No.
It should be going down. We do red. Where should this go? Should be going here and up or down? Down. Okay. So now if we do our cut, so now, this red is supposed to be glued to this red. Okay, so let's move this guy over there. Keep him fixed. So what I'm going to do is, I want to move this red to this red. Okay, so firstly I'm just going to move this here. So this is... That's how I change that. And this is moving to here. Okay, so everyone, I just translated that to there, like that. Okay. Now we're gonna take. We're not gonna glue these two, but these go in different directions. Okay. So what we're gonna do is gonna flip that guy over. Okay. So this is gonna stay the same. Okay, now flip this diagram over. Oliana, if I flip this guy over, what arrow should I put here? Going up or down?
Up.
And this guy is going down. Okay, so now I can glue along. Seal along, and I just have and Nikolai Tikhonov, what is this object?
The cylinder.
And as we saw before, when we cut the Möbius strip, from the center, you saw that we ended up with a cylinder. It wasn't an ordinary cylinder because somehow it had that twist in it. But if we were living on the cylinder, we could see that it was a cylinder. Okay. And the last thing we did was we took the Möbius strip and we cut it along the third and we cut it along the two thirds. So let's see if we can predict that. Is this okay? So gluing diamonds is really helpful because you can see the result of cutting without having to get some scissors and physically do the cut. Okay, so let's do the last one. Let's take our movie strip. Along the third and two thirds lines. Okay, so it's going to be this color code, so let's make it. This point here, whereabouts is this going to be identified on, let's start over here, green. Whereabouts on the Möbius strip am I going to be glued to?
The top right glue.
Over here, so I'm going to be here. And you know which direction is my arrow going to go?
Facing
downwards.
Downwards?
Oriana, this blue, whereabouts is that going to be glued to?
Right,
to the middle.
Down
to
the
and
middle, right?
Here,
facing
here.
Downwards.
So
to the middle, right?
Okay. And Nikolai, third row, this red is going to be glued, must be. Yeah, which direction, up or down?
That's down and that's up.
Good, this up and this down. Okay, good. And now let's do our cutting. Cut. Okay, somehow, and what is it we want to get? What is our... Do you remember, what are we supposed to get when we cut the Möbius strip along the third and the...
cylinder and another Möbius strip.
So if I steal Eva's again. We expect a cylinder and a Möbius beam. Okay, so let's see. Let's firstly observe that the guy in the middle, what is this guy?
It's already a Möbius strip.
It's a Möbius strip. Okay, so it just remains to turn this. See that these two put together are a cylinder. So here's a... Okay. So now let's move this guy up. point here. So I just move this. Yeah. Okay, and now we want to glue these two together, so let's do our flip thing again. So take this and flip it over. Okay, flip it over, now this is going the other direction. Flip it over, this is now going the other direction. And again, now we can seal them up. Okay. So we have a movie strip. See from the gluing diagram, which we can see if we hold them together. If I start on the Möbius strip, can I ever move on to the cylinder?
You can't.
If I'm only allowed to move along the Möbius strip. We say that this surface we've got is disconnected. We can't connect a point on this Möbius strip to a point on this cylinder by a path. So we're not allowed to jump, we're on the surface. And we can see it in our diagram, because if we start on this gluing diagram, we can never get to here. On the other hand, if there was somehow a blue here, and maybe already doing something, then I could connect the two because I could follow this, and then I'll be on the red, and I'll be able to connect to this point. Okay, but that wasn't what we had. So on the blue line, we can see that we weren't connected. So let me just roll it down. These are. Not connected. These cannot be connected.
То есть две компоненты связанности, два разных куска, две компоненты.
Okay, I might leave you with it for the game to play. So Möbius strip and the cylinder, those are two surfaces with edges. What were the surfaces without edges that we've seen today? What were surfaces without edges?
A sphere.
Sphere, and we had another one that we drew.
Torus.
Torus. Okay. Let's see if we can draw a gluing diagram for a torus. We've done a gluing diagram for a sphere. So earlier we saw that we did a sphere. What about for a torus?
Well, it's a rectangle where this side is glued to this side. This side is glued to this side. And this side is glued to this side.
Okay, so what I'd like you to do is to hold up your cylinder. Hold up your cylinder. Is it one over there? Okay. So you got your cylinder. which is the same, remember this, this Kuomintang diagram. How could you turn your cylinder into a torus?
By connecting these edges.
Okay, so it's sure, but
like
it. So, yeah, so your cylinder, imagine it's a cylinder. Now stretch out the cylinder. Okay, now stretch it out and bring it around a little bit. Is that also a cylinder?
Yes.
Okay, so how do I go from this cylinder to a torus? What do I need to do?
Connect the...
I need to glue these together.
Yeah.
So let's fill that with... And if I draw an intermediate step, so now, if this arrow is this arrow, okay, what I'd like you to do is tell me, how should I glue this edge to this edge? I've drawn an arrow here, so either I'm going to draw an arrow this way, or I'm going to draw an arrow this way. Which way should it go?
No, actually, they should face the this into the same to the same direction.
Maybe how if we translate this guy around.
Yeah.
Can you see that? Oh, I did that. So now I've got my, you see I just pulled it around, you see they're going in the same direction. Okay, now that's on this diagram. Now if we return to this was, this is the same as this gluing diagram. Okay, now let's see, can we see that, now what we'd like to do is draw arrows on this gluing diagram. Corresponding to these two arrows. So let's... Can we see how to draw the arrows in the gluing diagram? So remember, to go from this to this, we brought that around. Okay, so if you like... into that edge. Okay, it became one edge, just one point, one line. Now, as we go along here, see that? And we want to glue this reed, this line here, this edge here, and that will correspond in our gluing here. So a gluing diagram for the torus, which is this thing with these two identified. Is given by a rectangle with all edges identified in some way. The two greens are on the same direction and the two reds are on the same. Should we try it? You want to cut it out and see?
No, it's impossible. Well, it's not impossible, but... Oh,
we have a challenge.
Actually,
is it possible?
Yes.
I'm just going to put that. Okay, so I've got a handout for you to cut it out. So let's go. So I've drawn the torus in the middle just so you can see the.
Берите там ножницы.
Ну,
как бы. Ну и там клей или... Ну, сами если хотите, берите все что угодно.
With the one, again, cut along and glue so that the edges match up. Oh, it might be a bit difficult with the inside one. So I think if you throw the inside one on just to give you an indication to your member. So I can give you another piece of paper. Oh. It'd just be rather difficult to form it with the just the outside guy.
Just so this?
Yeah.
You mean that we shouldn't cut the
no.
inside?
Ignore the first inside guy.
А, вырезать внутренность не надо было?
Не надо было. А я бы
not just impossible, that's even hard.
Hard, but not impossible.
No, I mean, okay, that was supposed to be true. No, it is impossible.
Oh,
it's... Hello. It doesn't have to be pretty.
I mean, you see, if I
yeah.
try to connect,
yeah.
well, okay, there is a way. As a topologist, a topologist could do this.
Which is good, because we're topologists.
Well...
So one way if you want to...
Yeah, this time.
You could make your job a little bit easier with something. So it's not a pretty... Not a pretty torus.
Well, it's a longer torus, but that's a torus.
Okay, so it's not, but it's not flat. Right. Nicola, you gave up?
No, I'm trying to find where
oh.
it's
He's just trying to find the end of the
yeah.
tape roll.
But it's hard.
If it was
okay.
fancy, I...
Something like this.
Something like that. Just, should have some...
Well, yes, it should have some volume, but, you know, you're a topologist.
No,
you don't
no,
care
no.
about volume.
No. The point is that this point is not the same as that
Yes,
point.
I understand.
If it were flat, then
I found it.
I cheated.
Торус.
Торг. Не получается клеить. Без вот такого вот издевательства клеить не получается.
Well, so I think this is the well either Andrew's way or rolling up the small things and then gluing is maybe the only practical way. But you can see it's physically possible But you just, it's a matter of having the correct materials and maybe paper is a little. So this is your Taurus?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, so that's a Taurus, and I'll leave you with the game to play with Taurus. I'm not sure what the Russian translation is. In America they call it tic-tac-toe.
Ah.
Where I'm from, they call it noughts and crosses, zeros and crosses.
Yeah.
I know Noel and Klesk, I don't know if he's. What, how do you say?
Klesk.
Okay.
And how should.
Okay, so you know ordinary noughts and crosses.
Give me a second.
Okay. Wait, Klesk. Давайте лучше послушаем.
No, no, It's a very flat Taurus. See, flat Taurus is a... has a meaning in that. Okay.
Что лучше делать из теста?
Из железа.
Коль, не поверишь, там другие говорят, мы уже задумывались. Не ты придумал будет.
Okay, so just remember, everyone remember that if you're on the member part and just there is some inside to this Taurus. So,
yes.
So this point here is not the same as this point. So ideally this point here is not the same as the point on the back of the Taurus. So you kind of squeeze these together. Okay, so there's a Taurus and it's got this going in the back. Mm-hmm.
Так, это по-русски называется игра крестики-нолики.
Okay, so in regular tic-tac-toe, these should be a winning move. If three crosses, then you win. But let's play it on the Taurus instead. Tell me if I stay on the Taurus, so I'm going to draw a straight line. So I start here. And if I'm here, where do I go next?
To the left bottom corner.
This point.
Yes.
So there's another. So my winning move again is X. I'd like someone to come up to the board and draw me a winning move. By a winning move, I mean three X's arranged so that they stay on the same line, a straight line on the Taurus. So Andrew's already. So Andrew's going to give me a winning move that isn't a normal one, isn't it an unusual one?
Yeah.
Look.
Okay, yes. Well, if I put the cross here, across here and across here. This would be a winning move, because if we move from this point here, then here, and here.
And where does he go next? Back to here. See that? Okay, so the question then is, how many winning arrangements are there?
You mean all of them? I mean, if I just rotate that by 45 degrees, or wait, no, by 90 degrees.
So maybe
by 90 degrees. Is it another winning condition or the same one? If I rotate my condition by 90 degrees, is it the
just
same?
On my diagram, if the x's are in different places, then they'll be different. Just
okay.
But now, so I'd like to give you a homework activity. So right now, I'd like you to play this game. So I'd like you to get the pairs. You got pairs? Almost got pairs. Someone's going to play with you. I'm going to play with you, okay? Nikolai, Liana, Nikolai, Andrew, and what are your names? What is your name?
Darren.
And
Philip.
Darren, Philip, you're also going to play tic-tac-toe, okay? On the Taurus. Don't worry, I'm not very good. Okay, and see? See you. Eva, do you want to come to the ball with me? You can be red or green. Red? So I'm going to draw these three arrows go here, these two here. Is this, okay, this is the one side of the Taurus, and it's the other side of the Taurus.
Не загораживайте доску с собой, хорошо? Чуть-чуть в бок. Нет, не в этот бок, наоборот.
Where would I end up? What would be my next? If you were going along this way, where would you? So where is this point going to be? Going to be in the right way? On the tour?
Точку, с которой склеивается.
Let's see. Okay, I'm going to put my circle there. Did you win? Okay. Do you see how you might have won? Okay, I'm going to continue. Okay. So you blocked me. You blocked me. But can you see, could you see you might have won? Well, let's just continue. Okay, so you blocked me down. Let's see. I'll go. Yeah.
Okay,
you
blocked
me. Can anyone win?
Yeah. Who is the cross one? Who is the cross? Are you the cross? No. I mean, who plays for the red cross? Then you are the winner. Because you see. This is a winning combination. Alright.
That goes to here.
No, wait. You see, let me grab it.
Oh, no, you're absolutely right. Yes, you are.
Yes.
Okay, well done. Not only did I lose, but I lost by getting it incorrectly. Good. Okay. Well done. I lost. Okay, so have we decided how many... So here we just discovered one winning move, another winning move. Have we...
By the way, I understand that now I'll anyway win the battle. No matter where he puts... It's gross.
You're a strategist, okay.
Yeah,
кто может тогда след сделать? Андрей, можете объяснить?
Что объяснить?
Ну, что всегда выигрываете.
Нет, ну, я еще не всегда.
Всегда-всегда.
Нет, я еще не продумал для всегда.
Выйти и перебрать случай, это быстро.
Легко. Там
давай.
Же всего два варианта из-за симметрии.
Да, давай вперед. На чистой доске. Быстрее.
Oh, well,
yeah.
Мел возьми и на этой доске быстрее нарисуй доску. Да. Нет, первый ход делай крестики. Нет, никаких разных вариантов нет. Все клетки одинаковые. На торе можно смещать. Ему объяснять. Первый ход единственный, с точностью до симметрии. Что? The first cross. Слово есть такое симметрия. Ходите. Коля, говори громче, пожалуйста. Плевать, что ты знаешь, не знаешь. Говори в любом случае громче. Андрей, пойдете в качестве толмача? Как раз все поняли. Проблема в том, как отвечать. Надо ответить. Нет. Ход за крестиков выигрывающий. На каждый из двух. У нас есть два варианта игры. Крестики сделали первый ход.
Okay. Let's try to figure out the strategy. If I put the cross here, then the zero can be put either in a corner or in the center. Let's look at the corner variant.
Нет, налево косинтью, там уже нарисован.
Okay.
Да.
May I just know, I asked a simple question, so you guys have already decided what the strategy is. I just asked how many ways to win the game. Did we decide how many ways to win the game? So in ordinary noughts and crosses, how many ways are there to win?
Андрей, ну это же очевидно. Надо сейчас взять и сходить за крестиков.
Well, if I put it like this, then the zero must be here.
Так тут голову убейте, чтобы она не загрошилась. Да.
So, may I just pause? Everyone. How many ways are there to win a game of noughts and crosses?
Anyone. Yeah, I won.
Here is one way to win noughts and crosses. Here is another way to win noughts and crosses. So how many ways are there?
Так, нет, Андрей, отлично, вы один вариант разобрали и разобрали правильно. Теперь давайте в таком же духе второй вариант.
Я думаю,
I think. But, so that's what I'm asking on tourists. I'm not...
Да, все правильно. Берите свою голову. Итак, поставили крестик, поставили, да.
И он
выиграл.
Yes.
Нет, он выиграл.
Yes.
Нет, не вы, а он. Отлично. Все, вот теперь все случаи разобраны. Спасибо.
As I was saying, I was just asking how many ways are there to win? So in ordinary noughts and crosses, how many ways are there to win? Okay, so how many ways on the torus?
Well,
wait a second. Why 10 in ordinary? In ordinary tic-tac-toe, you have 8 ways. 3 horizontal, 3 vertical, and 2 diagonal.
And so now, how many extra ways are there to win on the torus?
Four more.
And so I like it. So okay, your homework then is to draw those four extra moves.
That's easy.
Draw out this thing. And then I'll give you one other thing. I'll leave you with. So not only I like you to draw
Так, я слово не могу прочитать. Что там слово? Нарисовать? Winning.
Okay, and then I like to do the same on what we call the Klein bottle.
And what do you want us to do with it? Do you want us just to draw it, or do we need to do this?
I'd like you to draw those ones as a warm-up, and then do the same for the Klein bottle, where the Klein bottle has the following blooming diagram. So it starts off like the torus. So we have our cylinder. And as we saw, that was the same as So remember the torus, we built it by taking the cylinder and gluing the two edges. Okay. Now for the Klein bottle, you do the same, but now instead of gluing this edge to this in the same this direction, you draw it in the opposite direction. Somehow there's a twist there. So I like it also write down or determine how many winning moves there are on the Klein bottle. Okay. where this side is matched to this side, going that way, but this side is matched to this side, going that way. It's a little bit more tricky. So that's homework.
Понимаешь, что нужно сделать? Нарисовать все выигрывающие тройки на бутылке клейна.